Okay, so let's look at race around condition. So which is very, very, very important condition. Sometimes people ask this in interview and all. So you'll be having some interview related to digital circuits. They might ask you about this. So this is a technical term, race around condition, which occurs in level triggered JK latches only. Okay, mind you, this problem or this condition is only in level triggered JK latches. Okay, so we have seen this gated latch, you can call it as JK type gated latch. Level triggered could be anything, a positive level or negative level, in both it can occur. But mostly what you will do is you will use active high type of latches only. So the negative level triggered I just gave you for your knowledge purpose. Mostly you will be using positive or positive level triggered only. So this is what it is. So it's a condition, technical term. It's a condition which happens only in level triggered JK latches, specifically when the input is J and K equal to 1. Okay, so it will not happen with other values of other inputs of J and K. It only happens when the inputs you will provide to J and K latches are 1 and 1. Okay, which is toggle situation. If you remember, positive triggered I am talking about, active high type I am talking about. So that's why 1 1, you can imagine. Always you will be using active high type. Okay, so that is what I am trying to say. Negative level triggered and active low type you won't see mostly. You will see active high type, positive level triggered only. So that's why I have taken here. So either it could be NAND or NOR, you can imagine anything, you don't have to go into details. What I'm trying to say is, when you are providing input 1 1 here, that's a toggle situation. Active high type I'm taking, J and K are input, so imagine NAND type of implementation would be there inside this. We don't care about that. Okay, and a clock is positive type, you can see that it's a level triggered. So what will happen? See, here I have taken the clock, just as an example I'm taking. So just enlarged it so that you can see all the parts. So the total clock time is T, in which you have on time, you have off time. Okay, let's say your on time, this guy on time is 5 seconds, and your TPDL means T propagation delay of your latch is 1 second. Okay, so it depends upon the TPD means propagation delay of JK latch. TPDL, it means how much time it is taking to produce the output. Okay, when the clock appears. So that is how you can imagine. So see how the problem is happening. Your T on time is this much, 5 second, and your latch is producing your output after 1 second. So what will happen to this output? I have made an arrow Q. So what will happen? Previous state could be either 0 or 1. So two condition can be possible. When your previous state is 0 and when your previous state is 1, next case. So let's see the first case. When the previous state is 0, the next state will be 1. Now since your on period, it is on only right now, so because your output is appearing after 1 second and your clock is having on time of 5 seconds, so it is positive level triggered for 5 seconds. So within 1 second you produce the output 1. Now the next 1 second you will produce output 0, next 1 second output 1, next 1 second output 0. So for 5 seconds, on period was still 5 seconds, and you can see how many times it is changing the output, right? It ideally it should change the output only once, right? Either it should have been stopped here or stopped here. Same thing you can imagine in this case also. Here the present state is 1, so next state will be 0. After 1 second, next state will be 1, next state will be 0, then 1. So for 5 seconds, these are the output. For 5 seconds, these are the outputs. You can see that why this problem is happening, because your propagation delay of your latch is less than your pulse width. Why I am writing pulse width? Because this problem can also occur in negative triggered type. Okay, so usually you don't do negative triggered, positive triggered only you will see. So you see that condition, we want our latch to change its output only once, but since this condition is holding, is being followed here, that's why the output is changing multiple times, which is not allowed. Now what will happen? Imagine a case where you have t on is equal to 10 seconds. It will change 10 times, right? If you have your propagation delay of latch half second, then also it will change 10 seconds, 10 times. If you will have your t on time 15 seconds, it will change with the TPDL is equal to 1 second, it will change 15 times. So you can see it is changing multiple times. You don't know at the end of your positive pulse how many times it has been changed. Clearly how many times it has been changed and what is the correct output, you will not be aware, right? Basically it is changing depending upon the times of your on time and the propagation delay time. But you don't want that. You don't want any of that. You want only once to change once. You want only once to change output. Q should change only once. Right, I hope I am able to visualize you the thing. Okay, so this condition is called as race around condition. The condition when the output of JK level triggered latch in toggle mode, JK level triggered is very important. Level triggered and toggle mode changes its state multiple times instead of changing once is called as race around condition. So this is the problem. So you don't want that because it becomes indeterminate to find which is the correct output. You will not know. Here you know, right? If the output will change only once, your previous state was 0, next state is 1. Your previous state was 1, your next state is 0. That is what it will happen. But if your output is changing multiple times, you don't know which was the previous state, which was the next state. Okay, so that's why it is happening. That's the problem. It is called as RAC or race around condition. And it is happening because of this condition. Why this condition, this race around condition will not happen with other inputs? Let's see here. So with J is equal to 1, K is equal to 0, or J is equal to 0, K is equal to 1, or J is equal to 0, K is equal to 0, it will not produce any issues. Okay, let's say an example I have taken. J is 1, K is 0, and we are holding same condition. T on is equal to 5 second, TPDL is 1 second. Then what will happen? See, let's say if you have previous state 0, since J is 1, K is 0, this is active high type, NAND type is active high type, right? So without NOT gates, so you can see that it will be set, right? Set. Now this will happen after 1 second and your on time is 5 second, clock is positive type, so still it will take this output, but the output will only be 1. Right, because it will only produce one output, so it will keep on 1 second, 2 second, 3 second, 4 second, 5 second. So it kept on producing one. It is not changing the output. It is not toggling the output. You can see that, right? That's why this is not causing any problem. So for all the whatever time your clock was on, after 1 second, it keeps on producing one only. So it is not changing the state. State change is the problem. Okay, similarly you can imagine 00, let's say 00 if you will imagine. Oh, by the way, if you had previous state was 1, here the previous state was 0, right? Or present state was 0, the next state was 1. If the present state is 1, next state will also be 1, right? You can imagine in this way, same, when 10 will be applied. So that is one example I will give you. Let's take another example. Let's apply 00, then what will happen? 00. If you apply 00, it's a no change condition, right? So if your Q was 0, it will still be 0 0 0 0, 1 2 3 4 5 5 seconds. Okay, at the end of your positive pulse still be showing 0, or if it was 1, it will still show 1. It is not changing the state of the output, right? That's why it is not a problem. These guys are not causing any problem. The only problem will be caused by J is equal to 1, K is equal to 1. I hope you got the feel what's the problem. So how we gonna solve it? So the first thing you might have guessed that we can keep the pulse width, we can keep the propagation delay propagation delay in between your clock period and your pulse width, okay, whatever the pulse width, here you have T on, right? Here you have T on, this is your T clock is, let me write T clock here so that it will be much more convenient. So T clock, it should be less, your propagation delay of your latch should be less than clock time and more than your pulse width. Now it could be your level triggered could be positive or negative, that's why you are keeping pulse width, else I could have written T on, okay, because it is working in positive level trigger. So this is common solution you can think of. Second is to use edge triggering. Why? Because you will the latch will not have so much time to change its output. Edge trigger will work in this edge only, so there will be a tick and that's all, your output will be generated, and the other times it won't work. We have seen that how it works, right? We'll be seeing more in flip-flop also. So you can use edge triggering. Third is, which I'll explain next, is master slave configuration. You can use something called master slave configuration with JK latch so that you will remove this race around condition. So you might have guessed this, right? It is straightforward. Edge triggering, I'll tell you later on. First, I will show you the solution of race around condition through master slave configuration, how this solves the problem of race around condition. Then we're gonna go to edge triggering, and you will automatically see that how edge triggering removes race around condition. Okay, first we will generate how edge triggering you can generate, and then we will look at the flip flops. The circuit will not change, right? So it will be same as gated latch only. The only change will be triggering, like edge will be coming, and how circuit will become sensitive to edge triggering rather than level triggering. That is what we will see. So I hope the problem is clear. Here I am telling you the problem. Next I'll be showing you the solution through master slave configuration, and then we're gonna move to flip flop. This solution you can already guess how it is working. So you can also use this. Okay. So let's see the master slave configuration.